What's happening, everyone? Nick here from TV Box Top, and welcome back to my channel. This unique looking mini PC from Ace Magic is called the Ace Magic Mighty 8008 Intel Core i9 Super High Performance RGB Windows 11 mini PC. So I'm really excited to check out its design and unusual features, and even more so to test its performance. In this review, I'll not only explore its performance under Windows, but I'll also dive into emulation gaming and alternative operating systems, as we now have a fully compatible working version of Android 13 x86 and news of FidoS being updated with an Android 11 subsystem. So if you are interested in these topics and would like to see what this mini PC can do, my full in-depth review is up next. Stay tuned. Are you looking to purchase an Android box or Windows mini PC and you are stuck trying to decide which is the best based on your budget or firmware needs? You should be aware of the pros and cons associated with each device, as having the latest Android or Windows software doesn't necessarily mean it's a good device. To assist you in making the right decision, I compiled two charts, one with the best Android boxes and the other with the best Windows mini PCs in spreadsheet formats, where you can compare all of their features, performance, and links to their purchase page to avoid fraud sellers. To view these charts, see the links in the description below this video. And now back to the review. So I'm back, and thanks for keeping it locked during that quick unboxing. And in this purchase, you get the high performance AD08 model itself. One HDMI cable, a 19 volts, 6.3 amps, 119 watts DC barrel type power supply, one 3-pin AC cable for the power supply, and a multi-language user manual. This unique design consists of a vertical standing body made of plastic with RGB lighting effects on its top and sides. At the top here, you have an appendage that looks like a military-grade flashlight that's actually a control selector for its internal cooling fan with three modes: auto, performance, and silent. Its power button is located at the edge of the fan selector, and it also has RGB lighting effects. For I/O, Tooth Ray has a pair of HDMI 2.0b ports, a pair of USB 3.0 ports, a reset button, a gigabit LAN port, a Kensington lock, and its DC input socket. At the front, it has another pair of USB 3.0 ports, a USB Type-C display port, and a headphone jack. To its base, it has two anti-skid rubber strips with ventilation holes. On one side, you have vents for its internal cooling fan. And on the opposite side, you have a magnetic cover that you simply remove to access its internal components, such as its RAM and M.2 SSD slot. You also have a SATA expandable storage compartment. And its RAM modules have RGB heat spreaders that can be seen through the semi-transparent magnetic cover. So I've already completed the Windows 11 first startup wizard, and here I'm on the Windows desktop. They pre-installed an RGB lighting control software to control its RGB lighting effects. With this software, you have five modes. You can set it to auto, rainbow, breathe, cycle, and you can turn it off because it can be very bright and there is no dimming feature. Also, it's programmed in the settings area to start up each time you boot into Windows. To disable it, simply open the Windows Startup App section and disable it. Its basic system information shows that the processor is an 11th generation Intel Core i9-11900H CPU with a base clock speed of 2.50 GHz. It has 16 GB of installed memory, and it's a 64-bit operating system. The version of Windows is Windows 11 Pro, and it's activated. For more hardware information, its CPU is an octa-core Intel i9 with 8 cores and 16 threads, codenamed Tiger Lake, with a max TDP of 45 watts. It has a base clock frequency of 2.5 GHz and a max turbo frequency of 4.9 GHz with 24 MB of L3 cache. It comes with 16 GB of DDR4 RAM, and this comes in two Juhor 8 GB 3200 RAM modules. Its GPU is the Intel UHD graphics with a max dynamic frequency of 1.45 GHz. It supports up to HDMI 2.0 B ports and has a max resolution of 4K 4069 by 2304p with OpenGL 4.6. Its audio is powered by the Intel Tiger Lake LM HDMI adapter, and I'll test it in a moment for surround sound audio. For storage, it comes with a generic NVMe M.2 512GB SSD, and here you can see the 1TB Western Digital SATA SSD I installed into the expandable storage compartment. Its network adapter is the dual band Realtek Wi-Fi 6 8852BE that also provides Bluetooth 5.2. And its USB Type-C port is a USB 3.2 generation 2.1 with a max transfer rate of 10 gigabits per second. So checking out some of its features, with its dual HDMI ports and its USB Type-C display port, you get three-way extended display with the ability to add a fourth via wireless display. For video processing, you get HDR10 and AV1 up to 4K 4069 by 2304p at 60Hz, depending on which display you are using. In this demonstration, I'm getting 4K 2160p at 60Hz with the HDR on my 4K Dolby Vision TV. Even though it can play Dolby Vision and HLG videos, it does not have the license to output the Dolby Vision format to trigger the feature on your TV. This is a 4K AV1 HDR10 video, and it plays without issues. This is a Dolby Vision video with Dolby Atmos audio, and as you can see, the video plays smoothly and the Dolby Atmos feature triggers on the TV. This one is an HDR10 Plus video, and it plays smoothly but in HDR10 format. This is an HLG video, and even though it cannot trigger the HLG feature on my TV, it still plays smoothly in HDR10 format. And this is a 4K Dolby Vision video in the M2TS format, which is a difficult video format to process, and here it plays smoothly, and it also triggers the Dolby Atmos audio feature. For surround sound audio, this mini PC covers all the surround sound audio formats. Once you are connected to a 5.1 or 7.1 speaker system or AV receiver, you will get the options to select between Dolby Atmos and DTS:X audio. If you select 5.1 or 7.1, you can get Dolby Atmos. Dolby Digital Plus. Whoa. What is this place? DTS HD Master Audio. Dolby Surround from Dolby Vision Videos. Dolby True HD.
Next, we have the center channel.
And DTS:X. For video editing, I'm really impressed that it handles 4K 30Hz video editing smoothly in Camtasia, which is one of the more widely used video editors. Here I have two 4K 30Hz video clips on the timeline, and I'm not experiencing any freezing or difficulty dragging video clips. More Movie streaming services such as Netflix on this model grants you up to 4K display quality with Dolby Atmos. This is due to having HDCP 2.3 protection, which protects outgoing HDMI signals from piracy. This feature automatically activates and deactivates when you begin watching a movie on Netflix using the dedicated app from the Microsoft Store or via the Chrome browser. So, onto some gaming. This is PUBG at 1080p with all graphics set to the lowest, and it averages a frame rate of 23 FPS at most. This is Destiny 2 at 1080p on medium graphics settings, and it's only rendering an average of 26 FPS. Let's have a look at some benchmarks. For RAM and internal storage, the NovaBench app recorded a RAM transfer speed of 7,889 MB per second. And from its M.2 NVMe SSD, it recorded a write speed of 1,737 MB per second and a read speed of 1,740 MB per second. In testing its dual Wi-Fi 6 bands and its gigabit LAN port based on my internet speed of 315 megabits per second, its 5 GHz band and gigabit LAN port achieved the maximum speed of my network. The 2.4 GHz band averaged only 165 megabits per second. For CPU, single-core and multi-core performance, with Geekbench 6, it recorded a single-core score of 2,051, and a multi-core score of 8,714. It was also determined that under Windows it has a maximum boost clock speed of 4.8 GHz. In benchmarking its GPU, the 3DMark TimeSpy test recorded a score of 772 with an average of 20 FPS, which is exactly what I got during the gaming segment a while ago. In the Windows version of the AnTuTu benchmark, it scored 707,103. And in the comprehensive PC Mark 10 benchmark, it recorded a score of 4,815 overall, it got a video editing score of 5,211, and a web browsing score of 8,600. So I'll now enter all of these benchmarks on my rankings chart, and let's see where it ranks. So here is my Master Mini PC rankings chart, and when I enter the scores, it ranks at position number 5 based on its PC Mark 10 benchmark score. Now, there are other scores here that are pretty high in comparison to models that rank higher, but one thing to note is that these models have the Intel Iris GPUs and this model does not, so that affects its performance. So to view this chart, it's best viewed on a big screen, preferably your desktop or laptop, where you can maximize it and compare its scores to other mini PCs in this list. I also provide links directly to the seller's page so you don't get scammed by fake sellers. A link to this chart can be found in the description below. So it comes with a SATA expandable storage port where you can install laptop-sized hard drives and SSDs. And on it, you can expand your storage into the terabytes, as well as you can install separate alternative operating systems totally independent of your Windows operating system, but utilizes all of the PC's hardware resources. Moving on to emulation and alternative operating systems. So I decided that with the advent of powerful Windows mini PCs, that I would move away from PS2 emulation and attempt PS3 emulation. So this is the popular PS3 emulator called RPCS3, and here I'm running Devil May Cry 4, and at default recommended settings I'm getting really good graphics rendering at 59 to 60 FPS. It drops to 46 FPS at times when there is more details on the screen. With much larger graphics intensive games such as God of War 3, it struggles dipping as low as 9 FPS during scenes with lots of action and details. So for alternative operating systems, I started with Android x86 version 16 that runs Android 13. The installation was successful with root access via the kernel SU application and everything. The only problem I got is that the old problem returned, where there is no audio via HDMI and only via its headphone jack. Maybe as the kernel on this version 16 was designed for 12th generation Intel CPUs and this one is version 11, it doesn't work. Maybe, I'm just saying. The next operating system I tried was FidoS, as it was brought to my attention that they upgraded the Android subsystem from Android 9 to Android 11. However, this is not the case, as I installed their latest version 17.1, and when I checked the Android subsystem, it's still Android 9. So this is quite disappointing, as you still cannot root the subsystem. I tried installing the Chrome OS Branch Framework server build, but I couldn't find the right build for this chipset. The final alternative operating system is the latest version of Ubuntu. It installs successfully and it works as it should, and it's fully functional. In summary, its Intel Core i9 CPU has lots of computing power than most mini PCs I've reviewed. It has a unique design with modern aesthetics with its RGB lighting. You get 3-way monitor display with dual HDMI and USB Type-C, and it has SATA expandable storage that you can use to expand your storage and to install alternative operating systems independent from your Windows system disk. There are a few things that would have made it better, but I don't believe these are deal breakers. So for this Intel Core i9 high performance RGB model, Ace Magic is offering 10% off the original price on Amazon with a coupon which I placed in the description below this video. The coupon is limited, so take advantage before it expires. Also, this link is an affiliate link, which means if you use it to purchase, I earn a small commission that I use for the upkeep of my channel and to acquire new products for review. So thanks in advance for using my link. And thanks for watching. If the information contained in my video was of value, then I only ask that you show some support by clicking the like button. I would really appreciate you take the time to do so, as it not only encourages me to keep going, but it also helps with the ratings. And if you just landed on one of my videos for the first time, then I urge you to click the subscribe button and ring that notifications bell to receive notifications when I release a new TV box or mini PC video or decide to do a giveaway. Thanks again for watching, stay connected, and see you in the next one.